horror movies I've been passionate about for as long as I can remember. Is really, I was introduced to rock and roll and horror movies pretty much at the same time. My mom was a huge horror fan and weaned me on all the horror movies from the 50s and the 60s, and then both my parents took me to see everything through the 70s, and yeah, so I'm hardcore. My five favorites, well, the first one has to be The Night of the Living Dead. I saw The Night of the Living Dead, I saw in the back seat of a Volkswagen at a drive-in with my mom and her best friend when I was probably, I don't know, 7 years old or something. The scene where the girl's got a spade and she's coming at her mom, and her mom is not really realizing the gravity of the situation, is wanting to think that it's her normal daughter, and it's not. And she ends up killing her mom with a spade, and just those stabbing motions. And I think that always was unsettling to me, and I think it stuck with me to this day. All right, and then I'd go on to say The Exorcist, which was never to me as scary as Night of the Living Dead. I think Linda Blair's character really appealed to me, but it's got all the components to make a really compelling movie, and it's a horror movie. It's a great drama, and it's scary at the same time, which I think is what appeals to me. And then another one on the same level, which is actually one of my standing favorite horror movies, is the original Omen with Gregory Peck, who's one of my favorite actors.
I was at the hospital, Mr. Thorne, the night your son was born. I saw its mother.
And really, that one was pretty scary for me, you know. With a great character, Damien, I mean, you know, what a fantastic concept. Really well put together and well directed. And then another one of my favorites is Rosemary's Baby, which is another amazingly well-written, scary story that's a classic sort of slow burn build up to, you know, crescendo at the end, and the acting is great. And people go, well, we don't need good actors sometimes. You know, sometimes that's the attitude in horror, but it's really essential to getting the right dramatic effect. You know, and let's see what else was on my list. The Thing. John Carpenter's The Thing, and the original is really good, and I won't take away from that, but John Carpenter's The Thing is just, you know, it's just one of the most visually appealing and hair-raising horror movies of all time. I think it's classic, and the visual effects are great, and most of it done by hand. It's not like it's all CGI or anything. That would be my top five at the moment, yeah.
You know, you get to see Frankenstein through the whole movie, like in The Creature, you get to see The Creature through the whole movie. I never got scared by a movie, but I remember seeing movies